Welcome to another episode of Fun Bros Food. You guys asked for it, so we gave it to you.
Korean barbecue!
Alright, we're at Gen BBQ in Alhambra, California, and we're with our Korean experts, Jinny and Gina.
안녕.
Plus our friend, Richie Lee.
안녕.
The first thing I ordered was chadobaegi, which is beef brisket.
Why is it brisket the first one?
Cooks fast, it fills you up.
What's that?
This is thinly sliced radish. If you're trying to watch your weight, this is probably the better thing that most Korean girls like to sit with.
And I've seen some Korean barbecue places that give you like a giant leaf, but I noticed here it's in salad mode. Can you guys explain that to me?
Well, the giant leaf, you're wrapping everything in the leaf. But this, you're wrapping it in the duck or the radish.
Create these things called dokbosan.
Dokbosan.
How important is it to have somebody attentive on the grill like that?
The great thing about this is if there's a little bit of pink, you can go ahead and eat it. Pigs, though, pig meat, we can't do that. So before we actually start eating, we all say 잘 먹겠습니다, meaning I'm going to eat very well today.
잘 먹겠습니다.
When you want to eat salad on our plate, you gotta get meat. Put it on top of your pickled jalapeno and the salad like this. You get the duck, you put it over.
Okay. Drone got some techniques. So when I'm making this little sandwich, I mean, most people just take whatever, or I'm gonna fix some kimchi with it. Cukes. Some cukes.
Even though this is Korean barbecue, you can put whatever you like, because it's America, right? Got freedom.
What I like about Korean barbecue is that you're actually eating a lot of grilled meats, but you're actually eating a lot of veggies with it too. One of my favorite things about Korean food is definitely a banchan, which is like the side dishes. And I love this because one, they're kind of free, but also it really helps balance out the meat. It kind of cools everything down, I feel like. This is like potato salad, right? And I kind of use that as like a creamer.
Balance.
So this is kind of like soy sauce based. The second one is my favorite, sesame oil with just salt and pepper. This is kind of just Gen Barbecue's kind of own twist. I'm not really sure.
I believe that's called green tea salt.
I know that one thing that the kids love, and I used to eat a lot when I was younger, was $10 Korean barbecue. Gen is not a $10 spot. Tell us the difference.
$10 spots, quality is not gonna be the greatest. Sometimes the meat has a lot of fat. Pig meats are really thin. They don't have too much variety. It's really, really frozen, and so it doesn't taste as fresh.
All right, break down the pork belly, because this is, for me, this is my personal favorite dish.
So these four right here is called samgyeopsal.
Samgyeopsal.
Koreans like pork marinated. This is the miso flavor. This is just the pork itself. This is wine flavor. I actually heard a lot of good things.
Purple.
Yeah, that was crazy.
And this one is actually really good, garlic flavor.
Can I cut that?
Yeah, you want to learn how to cook it?
Hold up, just go acting like I never ate Korean barbecue before.
Shoot, my bad.
So you hand it up from the top, and then you cut it from the bottom, because if you cut it right here, the meat's going to drop like that.
What?
And you got to pick it up again.
Start from the bottom, now we're here.
Start from the bottom.
A lot of people cut the bone out before you cook it.
We're not Korean. We don't need the bone.
This is called hanjeongsal, which is from the pork's neck.
Protect your neck, Wu-Tang Clan.
Here, champ.
A bit more fat in it. It tastes like butter. It's crispy.
Just put it on the grill.
Yeah, all right.
We gotta put this on. Now that the pig meats are here, is this ready to put garlic and stuff on?
Yes. Put it on the side though, so that it doesn't burn.
What about these jalapenos?
Gochu.
I actually heard that has a second meaning. Is this true?
A male's private part.
These penis. So I know with grilling, and this goes with anything you're grilling, like American steak, that you want to flip the meat as few times as possible. Because the more you flip it, the drier the meat's going to get. So what you want to do is start flipping the meat when you see the juice coming out on the side. And that's called flipping it when the meat's crying.
I'm crying, but the meat's crying.
Just try eating it. Like butter.
A chef once told me that for this, you want to just dip it in the salt because the sauces are going to overpower it. I'm hitting it with the salt. Mm. All right, these are two types of meat that we usually do not order.
This is the large intestine. This is the small intestine.
Asians eat weird things. Chinese eat intestine too sometimes, but we don't necessarily grill it like this. It's cool to see how other cultures eat their intestine.
Asians eat intestines.
Now that I'm older, I feel like everybody knows what Korean barbecue is. Everybody likes it and everybody's had it. You think that's true?
I think it's true. It's such a good environment.
It really fits in with like American culture because it's grilled meat. Every culture almost has their own version of grilled meats.
So one dating tip and advice. If you're a guy and you're taking a girl, you better be grabbing the tongs and the girl will just sit there being like, wow, oppa, oppa. The girls grabbing for it first.
Oh, what, you're saying you're in the friend zone?
Like, let me be your mom. We're not on a date.
Why do I want to be called Opa?
If you're being called Opa by a cute Korean girl, that means they respect you. They already see you as a man.
If you get called Dongsaeng, that's a bad thing.
So if a girl calls you Opa, that's good. If a girl calls you Dongsaeng,
friend zone.
And if a girl reaches for the tongs and cooks Korean barbecue for you, friend zone.
We're in the friend zone.
Yeah.
For the people at home, if they're at a Korean spot and they want to get the attention of a waiter or waitress, what would they say?
David, allow me. Yu-Gi-Oh!
That's it, right?
Yu-Gi-Oh!
After my Korean friends were at Korean barbecue, they might escalate their voice and it might become a Chogyo!
The reason why someone would say Yu-Gi-Oh! Basically meaning attention over here, attention over here. And then when they're not getting your attention, you're saying Chogyo, which means like, hey, you over there.
English translation.
Yogyo.
Excuse me, over here. I'd like some help.
Chogyo.
Hey, bro, over here.
Yogyo.
What did you just ask?
We asked to change the pan. It's getting really black. What you do with the meat, you just put it on the sides because the heat's a lot less there. This is a spicy marinated squid, calamari. We like to eat it raw though, when it's moving in your mouth.
And like, it's moving right now.
Squidward would not approve, SpongeBob.
To my knowledge, an important part of Korean barbecue is drinking alcohol. Here we got the shot glasses. We're not gonna do alcohol today. We got Sprite.
So if you're older, pouring to a younger person, it'll probably be a lot more casual. One-handed is fine. Look at her form though. She's like kind of tucking in,
taking it very timid. It doesn't matter how close you are.
But now my way of pouring is gonna change because he's older than me. So now I kind of have to hold it.
So now you're timid. I look very serious.
But if the older person is pouring, then they can pour it all over your hand.
Yeah, you can pour one-handed, casually, spill.
All right, Richie's younger than me, so this is gonna be fun. So you know, I'm just gonna eyes closed.
Oh! Okay, now Richie, you have to pour.
All right, I'm older, so I'm big boss like.
Richie, hurry up.
Careful.
My sister poured for me and I'm younger. You always have to drink away.
Okay.
Yeah. A little rude if you're younger and you do like a whole shot.
Come back.
Top 3 mistakes people make when eating Korean barbecue.
Okay, but first guys, let me take a selfie real quick.
Mistake number one. Letting the meat burn. Someone's gotta always be keeping an eye on the meat and flipping it when it's time to flip.
Someone wasn't paying attention.
Don't let it burn.
Number two, not asking to change the grill. Once it goes black, it's gotta go back, and don't be shy to ask. Just change the grill.
Mistake number three, not asking for certain things that don't just appear on the table.
Be assertive and ask.
All right, everybody, we got some meat grilling, we got some veggies grilling, we ate a bunch. That was it for the Korean barbecue episode of Fung Bros Food.
Make sure you let us know in the comment section below other types of food you want us to try. We out.
Peace.
Bye.
Hey, can you snip this? Thank you.